Hi, my name's Ilma, and I've been posting Christian blogs for 12 straight years every day. Today I'd like to share Exodus 8, verses 25 to 32. Here's the Word of God. Then Pharaoh called Moses and Aaron and said, "Go sacrifice to your God within the land." But Moses said, "It would not be right to do so, for the offerings we shall sacrifice to the Lord our God are an abomination to the Egyptians. If we sacrifice offerings abominable to the Egyptians before their eyes, will they not stone us? We must go 3 days' journey into the wilderness and sacrifice to the Lord our God, as he tells us." So Pharaoh said, "I will let you go to sacrifice to the Lord your God in the wilderness. Only you must not go very far away. Plead for me." Then Moses said, "Behold, I am going out from you, and I will plead with the Lord that the swarms of flies may depart from Pharaoh, from his servants, and from his people tomorrow. Only let not Pharaoh cheat again by not letting the people go to sacrifice to the Lord." So Moses went out from the Pharaoh and prayed to the Lord. And the Lord did as Moses asked and removed the swarms of flies from Pharaoh, from his servants, and from his people. Not one remained. But Pharaoh hardened his heart this time also and did not let the people go. Exodus 8, 25 to 32. And here's the poem I wrote inspired by those verses. The swarms of flies plagued, lifted up. When the swarms of flies plagued the Egyptians, Pharaoh told Moses that they can worship in Egypt. But Moses said it would not be a worship pleasing to God, since the Egyptians would stone them if they worshiped there. Pharaoh once again said he would release them to worship if Moses asks God to lift up the plague of the swarm of flies. Here's my commentary. Once again, for the fourth time, Pharaoh tricked Moses and did not honor his word to release the Israelites if the plague was lifted. It is interesting that when the plague is stopped, he goes back again to his wickedness. Isn't this also true in our lives in our world today? When we are not beset by troubles and sorrows, we forget to worship God and we go on our merry ways and our sinfulness. All that was required of Pharaoh was to give the Israelites time to worship the Lord out of Egypt. But he was so insecure to let go of his control and abuse over them. What a narcissistic, egotistical tyrant this king was. Reflection. What steers Pharaoh to cheat, lie, and deceive Moses? Human nature. We all have that tendency to cheat, to lie, and to deceive. But that is our natural tendency. If we believe in God and we lean on Him, those are going to be worked at by the Holy Spirit, because as soon as we believe, our faith will make us grow in recognizing the natural, and so we can do the supernatural, because the supernatural is not ours to do, but it's the Spirit of God that's doing it. So here we see the human tendency to be deceitful, because that was one of the things that we inherited from Adam and Eve, that they were deceived by the enemy. And so we have a bent towards that. If Christ didn't die for us, we will continue to do that. So if we live lives without Jesus, we will continue to be cheaters, liars, deceivers. Thanks for watching. I hope you check my website at ilmaarts.com for artworks, photographs, and a copy of this blog. Please subscribe to my channel on YouTube so I could make more videos, give you the Word of God. And if you haven't already, please check over 3,000 videos I've done in the last 12 years. I've been doing this daily. Just type on Google or YouTube search, ILMA'S Palm Devotional. Have a wonderful day.